tools for the job. I use this little socket set. It's a really nice little socket set. I think it's those two. You just have to have different sizes. Or you have to use one of these spanners.
Probably should have started filming this process earlier, because it will be good for whoever's disassembling or reassembling this cabinet. But I have to disassemble it to get it outside. So the first thing I have to do is, there's these little side bolts, right? And they literally go into the side of the control panel against a bracket, this bracket down here, duh. So these go in this way, I think, or the other way? I think it's this way. These go in this way. You have to unscrew them on both sides first. And then at the back of the control panel are these bolts. And there's four of them on here. One, two, three, four. And they literally go onto here. One, two, three, four. And then that whole control panel will lift off once you've disconnected all the connectors. So the connectors are kind of like, they're either color coded, so the red goes to red obviously on the control panel, and the square white one goes to the square white, and they're keyed, so you shouldn't be able to do it. This one here, I've just put a little red marker on, so you can see on the control panel, there's a red marker, so you know which side to go on, but these are keyed. I might have even put a red marker on those too. So connecting it back up is actually quite simple, but yeah, that control panel has to come off, and the sides have to come off, because it won't fit through a door. So this is how you get the sides off. This is a real pain in the ass, but you've got to do it. There's rubber strip that's got adhesive tape or something on the back of it. You literally have to rip that off to get to those side screws. So that stuff, you can either try and use adhesive spray to get it back on, or find some 30 mil double-sided adhesive tape. And you got to remove all this tape and put that tape back on it, and then stick it back to the sides when you put it back together again. So it's a bit of a pain in the ass job to do, but hopefully this kind of documents it a bit better. So those two strips. So yeah, once that gets off, if you get some like cleaning alcohol or something and clean off all the old residue, and then you have to put it back on. So you've got to do the reverse process. Also, so the monitor, there's a couple of support screws. There's these support screws that go into the frame, so two down there and two down the bottom. There was missing two, so I've got some replacements that aren't quite as big but still do the job, which are these ones here, with a washer, but they do the job. So you notice the monitor isn't falling out. It's a damn heavy monitor. It's because there is some support for the monitor, because you can actually take this monitor out and rotate it this way to, you see the control things, they go down to the bottom for landscape, or you have it this way for Tate, or you know, vertical games. What else? That's it. Oh yeah, when you disconnect it, and I've got to getting a LED light, but there's only a couple that come down from the monitor, a couple of cables. They'll be pretty obvious which ones are the RGB, etc., because they'll be the only ones that come from the monitor. And they're actually on the monitor, which I'll show when I take it out. So the taking the monitor out is a fucking big deal. It's heavy. Should be a two-person job, but a one person can do it. But I'm likely to put my back out, which would really suck. But I'm going to do it anyway. Here we go. You want to get in nice and snug. When you're lifting this, have it as close as possible to your thing. You don't have to worry about discharging this at all, because it's all contained within a cage. You're not touching the chassis or the anode. You're just literally using these handles here to lift it up and pull it out. And at the back, there's a little kind of a little like pole that's stuck into a little joiner. You have to actually lift the monitor up out of that pole and out to be able to get it out, which is what I'm about to do now. But the other thing is, I need to make sure that the cables come out as well, which can be, if they get stuck on stuff, it'll make my life very hard. So I'm gonna do it now. to get a good stance, as close as you can. Let's do it. Okay, make sure you don't knock anything. Hopefully those cables come out. Yep, they did. And just using bends your knees, you can rest the edge of the bracket on the ground, and she's out. Holy shit. So you'll notice there's two cables.
Woo! It's a big job. It's heavy as... So on the back of the monitor, I've just got this rubber mat down there. There's two cables. They're the ones that plug in for power and RGB. They're different connectors to the connectors on the ground. But once that's out, you can you can put it back in whichever orientation you want. But now it's easier to get into the cabinet to get the control panels and shit out. But that monitor's a real beast. It really is. This is what I mean about the pin at the back. There's a pin at the back here, that metal pin, that literally has to go into that slot there. So you have to lift it up and put it down. So putting it back in, you're kind of like fiddling with it and it gets fucking heavy. So having an extra person there to kind of help and support you would be good, even though only one person can really put it in at a time. So yeah, that's it. On the inside, it's a big metal shell. So I'm gonna take the sides off it now. Yeah.
So literally, yeah, just take these four screws off the side.
Two little screws, don't know if you can see them. One of these little socket wrenches comes in very handy with the different size attachments. It's very light once you get that monitor out, believe it or not. Small little screw that's just keeping that cowl, or bolt I should say, that's keeping that cowl on the side. There's eight or more of them. All the bolts look quite different, so it's easy to keep a track of what goes where.
There we have it. All that to get it through a door. All that to get it through a door. So you can see that in the manufacturing process, they've just used like epoxy resin everywhere. I reckon they did a few at a time.
I've just noticed that, never seen this before. Never even thought about it. But just like there was the rubber cover bumper here, there's actually supposed to be rubber here, but it's missing on both of them. So, yeah, down in this section here. So if you can find some 30mm rubber and adhesive tape, then you can put them on there.
So yeah, the whole thing should take about, I don't know, no more than half an hour, I would imagine. I guess this video will tell you. There it is. Wow. That is a sneaky one. So, right about here on the inside is a real freaking pain in the ass one to get to. And it's going to be a pain in the ass to get back on too. Done. Whee! Okay. Right. Well, after a lot of effort, I've got the side cowls off, control panel, monitor out. That's it. So now it should be side on. Should be thin enough to get through a door. All right. Hope you enjoyed that horrible process. Enjoy it yourself. If you want to pay me to put it back together, another $100. See ya.
Your door handles will have to come off if they're blocking the distance, and your door might even have to come off. It just depends. This is why you have to take the front off and the sides, because the sides actually mold around to the front of the cabinet. Anyway, that's how it is. Okay, with the door handle off, this is how close we are. Down the bottom, that's the wheels. And on this side, we're right near this thing. So you have to be really uber careful getting it through doors. So incredibly slow and cautious you gotta be. And she's through. So holding it just here to pull on it, and down on this bracket on the underside to pull at the same time is the best way to get it going sideways, but you've got to be able to slide it on your floor.
Okay, here we are. It's all disassembled. We've got the Nanao monitor. We've got the chassis, the side cowls, and the little kind of mats that go inside that side cowls. The side, that's the Mysticator on the, just on the board that slips in there. Coin box, that's actually underneath of the control panel that goes on the front, and the control panel. Now I'm just upside down, so it's not leaning on the joysticks, just holding it up. So this is the adhesive spray or double-sided tape, a couple of different versions of double-sided tape. I'm gonna try the tape first. Well, I can give you some tape anyway if you need it, pretty cheap, to put on these bits, the side rubber back on. So I'll see if I can get rid of that tape and put the other tape on. All right, that's it. So, you know, strongly advise transportation like this, to be honest. You could put the monitor back in and transport it like that, but I highly advise not putting the control panel on the sides on until you get it in your door and where you need it. If you have double doors, we can put it together back in the shed here and you can pick it up in one complete unit. Okay, I thought I should go over all the imperfections of the cab just for those that, you know, think that they're gonna buy a 1990s cab that's been through arcades and everywhere without a dent and it's gonna be factory fresh. It's not factory fresh, never will be. First thing you probably notice is at the right angle, you can't actually see them in person, but on the camera it's very clear. You can see there's a couple of dents on the on this. Most of the time it looks like that. You can't even see it. So you have to catch it at the right angle to see those. There you go. Nice shiny angle. They're mine. Obviously something's been bumped into it. The padding that is along the bottom of this, this is covered when the control panel goes down. It's obviously some fabric that was on there that is, you know, come off over time. There is plenty of, you know, scratches and stuff on the side. I'm just highlighting all this because I want it to be very, very clear. What you're buying is you're buying the originality of the cab in the current state it's in. This side looks pretty clean actually. This lights up nicely when it comes on. Okay, there's another chip, big one. Chip up the top, obviously something's messed with it. At the back, like some scrapes and dents kind of thing. They're the two side things. At the back, I mean, if you're worried about the back, then you probably, these are all covered by those cowls on the side. Then obviously there's the dent, a very obvious one at the bottom where some forklift or something has run into it. A few more scratches and dents there. This side, little dent in the middle, more scratches and dents. I mean, if you're expecting a showroom piece, you're not gonna get it, and you're never gonna get it, to be honest, unless it's never been used. What else on the side cowls? Obviously down the bottom, it's missing those two rubber bits down the bottom that go onto those, but generally, I mean, it's got some scratch. Generally, when it's all put together, it looks pretty cool. These don't really have a lot of issues, to be honest, which is surprising considering how much they stick out, you know, a few scratches and whatnot. Control panel itself, it's all fiberglass. They all look like this underneath. It's never had like big cracks or been sat on and broken and that kind of thing. The epoxy comes, can come off. These brackets can come off if you whack it or, you know, it falls or knocks or whatever. So that's the factory bracketing, where it's like that. And then you've got things like here where you've got, obviously it's come off and been re-epoxied with clear epoxy. But as long as it holds and it's functional, that's all the original stuff. The control panel stuff, I said before, there's some, you know, the laminates come up and it's obviously quite rusted under there where it's been exposed. A few scratches along the top, bit of ding just there that I saw. Where is it? Just there. But you know, there's no major structural problems with it. It's all kind of that original quality. I don't like it sitting on the joysticks too much. As I said before, the wires are actually soldered onto the control. You can take them off and put on quick connects if you want, clean it up. But that is, as you look at any control panel online, when you see the underneath of one of these Exceleenas, and it looks like that. It's fiberglass with epoxy to hold the bracketing on. This is underneath the control panel, so all the control panel wires come through the hole in the back, and this obviously sits underneath that control panel and bolts to the sides. This coin door goes to the bottom. The lock on this is not working, so you would have to replace the lock, but the lock on all the other bits work. I don't know why it doesn't turn, it just doesn't work. It's stuck in some way. But you know, the lock on that one works. I guess you can see the inside of it too now. It's in pretty good nick on the inside, obviously. It hasn't seen any storage issues more than you can imagine. That's the original transformer, obviously. The original power supplies. I think guy I bought this off a few years back, he recapped the power supply, he said. There is a whine when you first turn it on for like a minute or two, and it either goes away by itself or you just turn it off and on again and it's gone. And I don't know whether it's the monitor or the power supply. But the monitor's chassis has been being serviced by JOMAC, so I would imagine the monitor and the chassis is as good as it's going to get with the JOMAC service. So on the monitor, I said it before, the clear coating at one point has obviously been abrased a little bit. You can't see this at all when it's turned on. You can hardly see it now. I'm sure at the right angle with the right light it could. But again, as a full package, when it's put together, you've seen the videos. It looks great. So that's it. I do not want to have to put this back together here. If someone wants to buy it and they want me to help them put it back together at their place, I can do that. I'll probably add another, you know, 100 or something on top of it. I'm already going to discount this probably to get rid of it, because it's obviously in the way and I need the space for something else I'm getting. So that's it. 100% disclosure. Thanks guys, bye.